Dear all, welcome to this short tutorial on VEGAS Pro 18, one of the best video editors to realize custom videos and slideshows for both amateurs and professional users. It comes with amazing visual and audio effects, advanced color corrections, transitions, and also great text templates. Please take a look at our YouTube channel and our official website to get news, free tutorials, and participate in our exclusive giveaway campaigns. To start with a new VEGAS project, go to New Empty Project in the top left corner. This shows an empty timeline at the bottom and several panels and windows on top that you can close and reopen from the View tab under Window. You can import videos, images, and audio files by dragging and dropping these from any folder directly onto the timeline. You can also open VEGAS Capture from the Project Media window to record from your webcam or microphone from scratch. The timeline is the place where you edit and create your final video. All the imported files are shown as blocks called events or clips with video frames and images collected inside video tracks and audio content inside audio tracks, showing one audio waveform per channel, representing its volume level over time. On the right side, the video preview represents the timeline content where the black marker is placed in time. Click on it to fix the starting point and then use the player to play back in real time, using project video properties above to adjust resolution, frame rate, and advanced options, and preview quality to fix its quality. This new VEGAS version includes full hardware support on both HDR files and full range 8-bit pixel format with automatic GPU acceleration for the smoothest preview experience. You can get a faster preview by using the loop regions. If you click and hold on while dragging on the timeline, you create a blue loop region that also moves the marker. This way, you can check different frames forward or backwards in time without any audio. The same loop region is also used to play back its inner part in loop if you keep loop playback enabled. On the left side, you have several options to manage the content of each track. Right-click on any track to add, duplicate, or remove it. Whereas use the mute button to disable its whole content, and the solo button to disable all the other tracks but the current one. Moreover, you can use the level bar to adjust the opacity level of the whole video track content, the volume bar to adjust the volume level, and the panning bar to balance the left and the right stereo channels on audio tracks. Just make sure to check the decibel meter over time, avoiding any red volume level that can cause excessive distortion. Now let's see how to edit the timeline clips. First thing to do is to select the events to be modified. You can enable normal edit tool and click on any clip to edit it, or use the selection edit tool and click and drag to select multiple clips within the defined area. Once any clip is selected, you can move it within the same track or in another one. In case visual clips overlap in time, the ones placed on the top video track are shown in front of all the others inside lower video tracks. Videos with sound have frames and audio parts grouped unless you select and use the U key. You can cut, copy, and paste any clip by using Ctrl and X, C, and V respectively. This always acts on the clip event as a whole, unless you have a loop region on it. In this case, the only part within it will be affected. Use Ctrl and Z to undo if you make any mistake. To adjust the clip duration, click and drag its edges. If this becomes shorter, part of its content is cut. If longer, this is simply put in loop every time you see a marker at the top of it. Whereas if you drag its edges while holding down the control key, you adjust the clip duration by changing its speed rate, becoming faster if you shorten it, and slower if you stretch it, without creating any loop or changing the audio pitch. In case audio sounds distorted, you may need to adjust its pitch by right-clicking on the clip and going to Properties, enabling Lock to Stretch. In addition, if you zoom in on a clip enough, you get some buttons and handles. Pull down the top blue handle to adjust the opacity level on visual clips and the volume 1 on sound clips. Whereas use Event Pan Crop to open the Video Event FX panel, showing the visual clip content under a dashed rectangle that can be moved, sized from its nodes, and rotated from its dashed circle to change the way to show it. In particular, if you scale with lock aspect ratio enabled, you zoom in or out on the clip. If you do so with this disabled, you crop the clip instead. Whereas if you click on Event FX, you will get the full list of visual and audio effects available, depending on the kind of clip chosen. Select any effect from the list and use Add to apply it on the clip chain above. Add it in order from the left to the right. As you click on OK, you can select any effect to adjust its properties from the same panel while checking the preview. You can also return to Pan Crop to find and edit the dashed rectangle seen before. You can also make advanced color adjustments on clips by applying the color grading effect and opening its interface by using its button at the bottom. Here, correct colors and luminance on low lights, lift, mid lights, gamma, and highlights, gain, on all the RGB color channels, using offset to balance the color ranges. On the right, you can also get color curves and HSL options, including color shift with hue, saturation, and luminance on the overall clip. Use Exit to apply all and come back to the standard timeline. In VEGAS Pro 18, you get several new effects such as denoising, flicker noise control, and black bar filling. It also includes AI-driven tools like colorization and style transfer to give your clips a completely new set of colors, also similar to famous paintings. You can also add amazing transitions, which are special effects used to introduce or end any clip content. To add simple fade transitions, just drag any clip from its corners as much as you want it, longer and slower in time. This fades the opacity or the volume level in time, depending on the kind of clip, with an envelope that can be changed by right-clicking on it and going to Fade Type. You can also drop other special visual transitions from the Transitions panel using Transition Properties to adjust it if you need. With VEGAS Pro, you can also make static and animated titles with the templates inside the Media Generator panel under Titles and Text. Just drag and drop one on a video track to create a text clip and edit its content, style, color, and appearance by going to Generated Media, applying any animation to add nice effects or transitions on it. Make sure to place your text clip on a top video track, or it gets overlapped by other clips higher in position. To save the current status of your work, including the current marker position on the timeline, use Ctrl and S. This saves a .veg project file that you can reopen anytime. You can also use incremental save to save new .veg files, then include a counter for a correct versioning. Whereas if you need to turn your project into a final video, go to File and then to Render As. Selecting the format on the left and the ready template to use on the right. You can take Magic HEVC to export a .mp4 file for YouTube or any audio template to render just the audio content. Go to Customize Template to personalize and choose templates as you wish. At the bottom, set where to save the video and its name, using the Render button to start rendering. By default, the whole timeline gets rendered until the end of the last clip in time. You can also render any selected part within a loop region if you enable Render Loop Region Only under Render Options. Thank you very much for watching this video. Follow us on YouTube to find other amazing tutorials completely free to watch.